Hello friends, this video on motion in a straight line part 4 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exams. Please make sure that you have watched part 1, 2 and 3 before going ahead with part 4. Okay, now let us look at distance time graphs. Based on whatever we studied in path length, displacement, speed and velocity, we plot graphs of these quantities with respect to time. Let us take the same example where Ronnie is traveling from his home to McDonald's. Now let us suppose the distance between his home and McDonald's is 2 kilometers. This distance is 2 kilometers. And let us also consider that Ronnie travels or covers this 2 kilometers in 2 hours. Now what do we see? Ronnie goes from home to McDonald's and again comes back from McDonald's to home. Now in this scenario, we have to plot the distance time graph. So how do we plot the distance time graph? To plot a distance time graph, we consider the x-axis to be the time. So time is taken along this axis and distance is taken along the y-axis. Okay, now using the data, we see that Ronnie traveled 2 kilometers in the first 2 hours while going from home to McDonald's. He traveled 2 kilometers again in another 2 hours while coming back from McDonald's to home. That means he traveled 2 kilometers. So the distance is here. Let us suppose this is 2 kilometers in 2 hours. This is 2 hours. That means 2 kilometers in 2 hours. So in the first 2 hours, he traveled 2 kilometers. Then in the next 2 hours, that means 2 hours from this 2. This is my 2 hour. This is 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour. Fourth hour. I'm sorry. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. These are in hours. I'm expressing time in hours. So what it says that in the first 2 hours, it travels 2 kilometers. In the next 2 hours, so next 2 hours would be 1 hour plus 2 hour. So next 2 hours, it again travels next 2 kilometers. So next 2 kilometers would be 1, 2. So in next 2 hours, it again travels 2 kilometers. So that point will come somewhere like this. So now, if you plot a graph, you will get somewhere like this. So the point is like, it is just an approximate graph. So the point comes somewhere here. So I hope it is clear to you now. So when we plot distance with time, we plot how much distance is covered in how much time. So in this case, 2 kilometers was covered in first 2 hours. Again, 2 more kilometers was covered in the next 2 hours. So our graph was a straight line. The points to remember when we talk of distance time graph is, time is always taken along x-axis, distance is taken along y-axis. Now let us see, what do we interpret from a distance time graph? So this is how a normal distance time graph looks like. It is a straight line. Now the slope of this straight line is nothing but speed. Now how do we know that the slope of this line would be speed? Now just to remind, this x-axis is nothing but time. Y-axis will represent nothing but the distance. So when we are talking of distance time graph, we mean to say path length time graph. So do not get confused with the terminologies. Now let us have a quick mathematical calculation or a mathematical review here. We know that equation of any straight line is y is equal to mx plus c. What is m? M is the slope of the line and c is the intercept on, in general, the equation of a straight line. Now, here also we have a straight line. But in this case, we can see that the value of c is equal to this value of c is equal to 0 because there is no intercept as it starts from the origin. Correct? So, in this case, y turns out to be m into x. So, m is nothing but the slope of the line. So, the slope of the line, that is m, is equal to y by x. That means the value of y by value of x. Now, let us consider in this figure, what would be the value of y and what would be the value of x. Suppose I rejoin it like this. Now, the value of y corresponding to this line would be 4. So, y is equal to 4. And the value of x corresponding to this line or this point would be 4 again. So, slope of the curve would be y by x, that is 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. Also, from trigonometry, we can say that if this angle is theta, in that case, y by x, this is y and this is x. So, y by x is nothing but tan of theta. We studied all these basic relations in our trigonometry of mathematics. So, what do we find? That slope of this curve is nothing but y by x. Now, what is y in our distance time graph? Y is nothing but distance. So, we can write this is as distance. And x is nothing but time. That means the slope is equal to distance by time. What is distance by time? It is nothing but speed. So, we proved that the slope of a distance time graph is nothing but speed. So, when we talk of distance time graph, slope of a distance time graph is equal to speed. I hope it is clear. If you want, we can do a quick review. We plot a distance time graph. If it comes out to be a straight line, then the slope of this line is equal to the speed of the particle. Thank you. Visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more.